Hi, I'm Dr. Lee. Welcome to Practical Pain Management. In this video, I'll talk about spinal anomalies, annoying spinal interventionist in the lumbar transforaminal epidural approach. The transforaminal epidural or selective lumbar steroid injection is one of the most frequently practiced pain clinic procedures. This procedure aims to relieve radicular symptoms due to foraminal stenosis and paramedian or lateral disc herniation. But it's not always easy. I have encountered challenging cases every day. Which one do you have difficulties with during the procedure? Would you select one of them? Indistinct image. It is the first challenging type. It is a lumbar AP view, and my target is right L5 nerve root. I cannot see the distinct cortical margin of the structure, such as inferior border of transverse process and lateral border of inferior articular process. The leading cause of faint image is osteoporosis in this patient. She has implanted multiple acupuncture needles. In the lateral view, there is a narrow disc space at L4-5, L5-S1 disc space, and the normal inclination angle of L5. Please keep this angle in mind. Excessive inclination of vertebral body on a sagittal plane. It is the second challenging type. The inclination angle of L5 vertebral body is larger than the standard variation. Please compare with the previous patient. To align the inferior end plate of the target, I have to tilt cranially to the extent of the inclination angle. Please look at the CM cranial tilting angle. And the needle has to follow the same angle with the CM angle inclination. It makes it challenging to control the needle. More angulation, more difficult. It is the third challenging type. The excessive outer proliferation of the inferior articular process and facet joint on a coronal plane make me annoyed. In this case, she has broad inferior articular process. The indistinct lateral border of lamina is caused by overlying bony sclerosis. Why is wide lamina causes of troublesome? To visualize the cervical triangle, I have to rotate the CM excessively. It also makes me challenging to control the needle. It is another case of a broad inferior articular process with indistinct margin. Overlying bony sclerosis and osteoporosis is caused the indistinct lateral margin. I have to rotate the CM excessively. To make things worse, the iliac crest obstructed needle pathway. It is fourth challenging type. Excessive downward inclination of a transverse process and osteophyte formation could block the needle pathway. Let's pay attention to the transverse process. It is difficult to observe the inferior border of transverse process of L4. There is an excessive downward inclination of transverse process of right L5. I have to puncture the skin inferior and lateral to the usual target. In this case, my target is right L4 foramina. The cause of excessive inclination of transverse process is the right inferior side bending of L4 body and ipsilateral rotation of segment. The sclerosis of L4-L5 vertebral bodies make the transverse and inferior articular process indistinct. Because of ipsilateral rotation, I have to rotate the CM more excessively and in turn make me challenging to control the needle. It is a fifth challenging type. The metallic instrument can block the needle pathway and make it hard to clear the needle. My target is L3-4 intersegment, which is the level of broken metallic bars. It is challenging to find the safe triangle or opening of intervertebral foramina. It is the most challenging time. All the bad anomalies are combined in the elderly patients. It is lumbar AP view. My target is left L5 nerve root. There is a downward inclination of the transverse process, indistinct lateral board of inferior articular process. The bony sclerosis of the vertebral body makes it worse to clear the target and its borders. Left oblique view shows the iliac crest blocking the needle pathway. The excessive inclination of L5 inferior border and narrow disc space make it hard to insert a needle. These are annoying anomalies. Causes of a faint and indistinct image are osteoporosis, sclerotic vertebral body, instrument and bone cement implantation, sometimes poor quality of image intensifying tube, excessive inclination of vertebral body on sagittal plane, usually flexion in lower lumbar and extension in upper lumbar area, downward inclination of a transverse process and indistinct inferior border on coronal plane, excessive outer proliferation of inferior articular process and facet joint on a coronal plane. The metallic instrument can block the needle pathway by its high radial density. It is the most challenging type. All the bad anomalies are combined. What are your annoying anomalies of the spine? What is your answer? There are several solutions to that problem. Contralateral oblique CM view is a good solution. I'll show you detailed CM anatomy and application in the near future. My target is right L4 root, but on AP image and right oblique image, bone cement hides the target by its strong density. It is contrast media infiltrating scene with a contralateral oblique CM image. The target is outside from the bone cement. Right image is an AP image with contrast infiltration. Let me show you one more example. It is an ipsilateral oblique and contralateral oblique image. In the ipsilateral oblique image, the target is very obscure and not easy to measure the needle depth. On the other hand, contralateral oblique image gives me information on the needle depth. The left image is the contrast infiltration scene. With this image, I can confirm the epidural contrast spread. Right image is the lateral view demonstrating the contrast filling in the L4-L5 epidural space. In addition to contralateral oblique CM image guide, there are several options: interlaminar injection, facet joint injection, and intradiscal injection. I'll talk about this topic shortly. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.